Did you ever see Apocalypto, the Mel Gibson movie about the Mayans? Sure. So I think, too, of when they're talking, they're looking at the eclipse happening. And of course, some of them believe that would be the end of the world, all that. So things like that. Now, many ancient cultures practice these sort of rites. Some still do to this day. Of course, it's not common, but certain remote tribes. So divination, of course, we know in our modern world doesn't work, but they've made the point that it serves a social function, that it sort of binds groups together and it sort of gives people, it gives people in power this sort of authority over other people because they can use it to control them. And I was thinking of in Apocalypto, there's a scene where the eclipse is happening and the priests and the kings sort of smile at each other. And the reason for that is because the Mayans were trained astronomers, so they actually understood how an eclipse was happening. But the general masses thought, oh, no, the world is ending. But they knew, okay, good, we can use this to control people. So that's one such example. And some cultures just retain these ideas because just general inertia and tradition. I always think of Fiddler on the Roof with the tradition song and all that. So now, why are we bringing this up? Well, I'll get into this and you'll start to see why. So
that's a good, to break in, that's a good analogy because I think there's a similar thing like that in politics where when it comes around to elections, they, oh, think about the kids. The kids are the future. If we just get degrees, we get free education. We have the credentials, or we have the most educated voters. They kind of throw that out there. Yet behind the scenes, you have something like that. That scandal that came out with the people paying for influence to get into the university, certain elite people. And it was people from celebrities, from politicians on both sides of the aisle. They understand that it's not really just because you go to university, just because you get the credential, doesn't mean you're going to actually get certain things. They know behind the scenes, we know how these things work, and we can use this as a little bauble to kind of trick the people. Yeah.
Well, I don't know if you saw, but on Twitter, some of the people are getting roasted because they're talking about the comments from the debate last night about children being smuggled in via coyotes. And some people thought he was talking about the animal. So like David Hogg got accepted into Harvard. He said that everyone, I think you sent me that, right? That was the one you sent me. And then there was another woman who's a corporate lawyer who said the same thing. Everyone's like, wait, you're a corporate lawyer. And I saw Channing Tatum wrote, must be an affirmative action hire. And he himself, not Channing Tatum, sorry, Brandon Tatum. It was another Channing Tatum's an actor.
Yeah, Channing Tatum is an actor.
Yeah, Brandon, he's an actor. Tatum. But Brandon Tatum. But he's black, and he's like, oh, must be an affirmative action hire. So it's like things like that, where it's like these are Ivy League or higher up educated people, and it's like they actually thought he literally meant like, oh, children are riding coyotes over the border and stuff.
Okay, with that one again, it's also with the information and the way we take in things, where things come out, and this goes to this whole misunderstanding. This goes to the whole thing where when the eclipse happens, people think something due to the different information they have about it. This is one thing I keep saying, is problems occur not because of how we define X, but because of not because of what X is, but because of how we define X. So these people, I think, in general, when they think of immigration, they automatically think of just people coming across, it's with their parents and all these kind of things. They don't have an idea in their mind that encompasses any kind of illegal migration, where a situation can be bad enough for you to actually risk sending your child with somebody else or hiring gangsters to actually pay them thousands of dollars and actually get them across the border. And then that happens at the end. That's not something that factors into their mind. So I think when they're thinking about the coyotes, I don't think they actually literally think. It seemed from the wording that at least with one of them, with the state rep, that she might have literally been thinking about the animal itself. But with the hog thing, I'll give him this much of an extent, where he specifically said, you're talking about parents. Because in his mind, he can't picture any other form of immigration that isn't just like your average family trip across a somewhat dangerous place to kind of go and stay. So in his mind, he's thinking, there are no kids. There's no possible way a child would come across the border unless they had their actual blood relative parents with them. Yeah. So in that kind of mentality, if somebody's being referred to as a coyote, he thinks it's a pejorative term about the parents, because those are the only people who would possibly have kids. They can't factor in. And that's the weird thing to me, that they can't factor that actual part in. And that's just how with some people, they can't factor in that that Eclipse is not some gods pulling out this thing, because that's not, it's something that they haven't been taught, where just the same way the people who, the Mayans, were controlling the information about what's happening in the world to the people, and then they just trusted that authority. It's the same way that this state rep, it's the same way David Hogg has actually just accepted what's in there, and he's been accepted to this institution of higher learning, which is reaffirming that my mindset, there's no way this school of Harvard that is so amazing would allow me in if I was this wrong about my perception about the world. Mm-hmm. So that kind of stuff reinforces the things. It's like, there's no possible way that our Mayan civilization would be this successful, and I would be honored to attend this activity unless these rulers were actually right about what portends with the whole, like, it's so messed up. It's a big aside that we've gone through to start here. But yeah, it's a messed up situation.
Yeah.
Thank you for listening. This has been a clip from an actual longer recording that I'll try to leave a link to on the screen or somewhere around here where you're listening to this.
Peasants.
Okay.